Hi, my name is Anupriya, and today me and you are going to introspect about ourselves. Friends, if I ask you a question that what is the similarity among all the successful people out there in the world, so what would you reply? I have the answer. That is their self-confidence. Yes, they are very much confident about their action, their decision, their thinking, their every single part what they do. They are very much sure that yes, I am doing this and this will bring me the right result. So in today's session, I will try to let you understand about yourself and I'll try to boost your confidence just to let you know that yes, you have also this important ingredient somewhere hidden in yourself and you can also achieve your goal if you increase it. Friends, if you need to go on the another floor where you are living, suppose if you are living on the ground floor and you need to go on the first floor, so what do? You go by elevator, or if there's no elevator, you just take the help of stairs. So when you take the stairs, what do? You just take first step, second step, third step, and then further. So self-confidence or increasing your confidence is the first important step of your life that gives you a reason, that gives you an important reason to achieve your goal or to achieve the set target that you have in your mind somewhere very important. So I have some very important remedies in my kitty for you today just to let you understand and boost your confidence going towards all this. All right. First, I have written here, face your enemy. As we know, self-confidence is a very good guy. And all the good people out there have some enemies. Definitely they do have. So what is happening? This confidence also have a big enemy. And that is fear. What are you afraid of? Why do you fear? And what do you fear about? Do you fear about getting rejected? Do you have the fear of rejection or committing mistakes again and again or getting insulted or getting failure? What fear do you have exactly? The first time you are going to do any work in your life, so you have not done it earlier. It means you have nothing to lose till the time you start doing that exactly work. So when you have nothing to lose, why do you afraid? What fear do you carry? So face your enemies of all such enemies. And how can you face it? You just can face it by removing it. Don't carry all such things in your heart that you will get insulted if you start speaking English before someone else, or you will get rejected if you don't perform good in the interview of a job. No, don't do it. Unless you don't perform, you can never understand yourself. And self-confidence is very much about knowing yourself. So do face your enemy and remove it completely from your life. Stop comparing yourself. The person living next to you, the very much neighbor or friend of yours, carrying a lots of good traits in his personality, and you are getting envy, you have a jealousy in your heart that why that person is doing good in his career. It means that you are comparing yourself with the another one. Friends, your own hand does not carry each finger equal. They are different with one another. So how can you think that each human being in this world will carry the same traits? Suppose if the great cricketer like Sachin Tendulkar would have compared himself with any other great Hollywood actor, so how he would have been such a great player? How would have been privileged to see him playing on the ground? He never compared himself. He did what he was made for. He used his potential that he carried. So comparing yourself is just a wasting of time. Instead of comparing, you can develop the traits the other person is already having, because when you will compare, the disappointment will occur in your mind and heart. And when you'll be disappointed, definitely you'll not be able to boost up your confidence. That will be badly crushed. So don't compare yourself. Stop comparing yourself. This is not going to help you increasing your confidence. Practice the positive. positive. Guys, your mind is the engine of your body. Your body is driven by a very much positive energy. And because your mind lies on the top floor of your body, so what happens if the energy of your body is positive? So it runs in the upper floor, all right? And when there is everything beautiful, good and positive is collected in your mind, so everything happens in your life very well. Everything happens beautiful. Everything positive, everything becomes very much positive in your life. But if it is negative, so what happens? The whole energy flows in the down manner. So your mind is completely empty. It does not carry anything worth or useful. And that's why you are not able to perform or work in a good manner. So if you practice the positive, it means if you do all the good things in your life, if you are in the company of good people around you, if you adopt those traits that are actually helpful for your personality, then it is all about practicing the positive things. Just model the successful people. I mean, just see them, that what they practice, then you can be actually able to follow their way and you can be actually able to increase your, boost up your confidence by doing this. All right. Past does not equal to present. You are afraid of just because last year you applied for a job and you got rejected. And same may happen today also. If you're going to apply for the job, you may get rejected. Why? Why the shadow of the past is still influencing your present? This is a sin. It may happen that you're again going to apply for a job and you'll get selected. Just because the fear of getting rejected of your past, this experience is not allowing you to work hard for applying again in a job interview. So if you'll keep on relating with the failures of your past, definitely you are spoiling your present. And this is also crushing your confidence very badly. So stop doing this. Avail your present. Alright? This is important. The past habits or the failures of your past is not as much important. Stop doing this. Be good to yourself. I have something I'll show you. What is this? This is a 100 rupee note. Alright? Suppose if I crush it badly, or if I fold it like anything, or if I use it to wipe my face or throw it somewhere, so it cannot be reused. But still, the worth of this piece of paper is 100 rupee note. Still, it will be called a note of 100 rupees. Similarly, you are also worth of something. You are also carrying your own traits. It doesn't matter, or it is not important, that how you are using yourself or how you are putting yourself before the other people. Your worth will be same. You don't recognize your worth, that is a different issue. That is your fault if you don't understand yourself completely. So be good to yourself means just identify your own worth. If you will value your own worth, if you will love your own worth, I assure you that you will feel so good about yourself. You will be more handsome or beautiful from inner side, that will definitely look at your face and your body language. And if it happens, the other people start loving you. And when the other people start loving you, definitely your confidence is going to be upper and booster, because you will get to know that yes, I am also existing somewhere as a very important person in this world. So be good to yourself. Wear a good smile. It is not going to cost you anything. Alright? Just compliment the other people. Just follow all the beautiful traits that you think that yes, if I do this, definitely I'll get appreciated. Or if I appreciate the others, definitely the same person will appreciate me. So be good to yourself. And end of the lesson, you don't have to be perfect all the time. All friends out there, try to be spontaneous. Definitely, grooming yourself is very important. Practicing the good thing is very important. But if you will keep on trying to to become perfect, so it may also lead you somewhere to the imperfection. Try to be spontaneous and then practicing your own traits. If you have the trait of cooking, you're a housemaker, so work on that. All right, don't force yourself to work on that. Don't burn your energy thinking about every time taking a stress, because sometime to become a perfect person, what you do, you just adopt the habit of taking stress. So just remove this from your mind, just remove all this negativity, and don't put your effort every time to become a perfect person in the world. Be what you are and just be happy and be grateful for what you have. That is the most important. And if you'll keep on developing all the traits you carry in your mind and body, definitely you are going to be most confident person in the world, and it is going to help you to achieve your goal. So do follow it. Bye.